We're gonna play a game called Brussels sprouts. So let me show you how to play.
We're gonna start with a couple crosses.
And here's what we do. So on player one's turn, they can connect any two of these free ends. So player one might go like that. And then you need to put a slash through the curve you've just drawn to create two new ends like this. So that would be one player's turn. And then player two would go. Player two might connect to this end and draw a slash through. And then it'll be player one's turn again. Player one might do this. You can't draw through an edge that's already there. So another turn might look like this. And the game goes on like that, alternating player one and player two. So the player that wins is going to be the last person that makes a legal move. So at some point, if there's no more moves that you can make, then the other player will win. You wanna play?
I'll give it a go.
Maybe we'll use some colors?
Yeah.
I'll play blue, you play red.
Okay, Brady is red.
So why don't you start?
Okay, I will play that.
Okay, I am going to do this. So this isn't really a fair fight because I'm really good at Brussels sprouts.
Oh, you're good at it.
Yeah.
You've got a good strategy, have you?
Yes.
I'm gonna play.
Copying me, I see. I am going to do this.
I will play through the middle here.
I'll do this one. I'll do this. Yeah, you lost, I'm sorry. You shouldn't feel too bad about losing because as I said, I'm really good at Brussels sprouts. And actually, it's not really a game, it's more of a mathematical trick. So no matter how you would have played, I claim that this game of Brussels sprouts was always going to have 8 moves. So because I had you go first, you were always going to lose because the number of moves was even, so player two would make the last legal move. So I want to show you how we know that there's always 8 moves because it's really cool. Okay, so let's look at this picture that we have, our finished game of Brussels sprouts. So I'm going to do something. I'm just going to make these crosses a little bigger so they're easier to see. So I'm just going to fatten them up a little bit. And I'm going to call these dots vertices. Let's see, did I get them all? I did. So this kind of picture that we have here where we have dots that are vertices and edges connecting them, where the edges aren't crossing over each other. That's what's called a planar graph. And planar graphs, we have this cool mathematical fact. So for any connected planar graph like this one, the number of vertices minus the number of edges plus the number of faces is always equal to 2. So this is like a really...
Not too factorial.
Yeah, sorry. Too excitement. Sorry, that's not a factorial. Although 2 factorial is 2, so we'd be okay either way. So I'm enthusiastic about this fact because it's really cool and it's useful in lots of different things. It's called the Euler characteristic.
That guy Euler?
Yeah, so he did a lot of things, including this. So we have this fact for all planar graphs, and I claim that we can use this to study the game of Brussels sprouts. So shall we do it? So let's say that we have a game of Brussels sprouts, and it ends after M moves. Okay, so this is just gonna be the number of moves until the end of the game, and I'm gonna try to show that that number has to be 8. So if we're going to use the Euler characteristic, we need to count some things. So we need to count the number of vertices, edges, and faces. So at the end of the game, I want to count the number of vertices, the number of edges, and the number of faces. Okay, so let's figure it out. When we started the game, we had just these two crosses like this. So we had 2 vertices at the beginning. Now, what happens when we make a move? So the first move, we connected 2 of these ends, and we put a slash through. That creates a new vertex. So we started with 2 of them, but every time we do a move, we get another one. So if we have M moves, we have 2 plus M of the vertices. Does that make sense? Okay, so now I need to count edges. So let's look at our moves again. So when I make a move, I'm drawing an edge. But then remember I cut it in half. So actually I drew 2 edges. We started with no edges in the beginning. When we started the game, there were nothing connecting our vertices. So we had 0 edges at the beginning, and on each turn, we created 2. So at the end, we have 2 times the number of turns. Now, faces is the trickiest one. So let's look back at our picture here of our completed game of Brussels sprouts. So When we count faces, I should have mentioned earlier, that when you count faces, what is a face? It's these regions that are bounded by the edges, except that we also count all of the outside as one of the faces. So over here, I need to count these faces. So if we look at the picture at the end of the game, every face has one free end in it. You know, if it had two free ends in it, the game wouldn't be over because somebody could just connect those two ends. So we can only have one free end at the end of the game. So each face has one of those ends in it, and those things are actually easier to count. So instead of counting the number of faces, I'll just notice that's the same as the number of free ends.
Teena, how do we know there can't be an end state in which there's a face with no free ends in it?
Yeah, you have to think a little bit about how the faces are created. So maybe we should look at like this partially done one. How are the faces created? Well, we get faces when we add an edge and a slash. And so every time we're closing off one of those faces, we're automatically getting a little free end inside it. So there never exists a face that doesn't have one of those ends in it. So we just need to know there can't be more than one. Okay, so we count the number of free ends. And why is that easier to count? Well, at the beginning of the game, how many did we have? So we had four on each of our little crosses. So we started with eight of them. On each turn, you use up two of them, right? We use up these two. They're not free anymore. But we create two more. So after one turn, there are still eight. And the same thing is true after every other turn. We use up two of them, but we make two more. So we use up two of them, but we make two more. So there are always, if you count, we still have eight. And in fact, we always are going to have eight. So the number of free ends is eight, which means our faces have to be eight. So maybe we should have done this one as an example. So in this example, for instance, if we count vertices, there are 10 vertices. Then I'm supposed to subtract the number of edges. There are 16 edges. And I'm supposed to add the number of faces. So these faces are their regions. So it's 7. But then I also count everything outside the graph as a region, so eight. And then we get two, like we were supposed to. Okay, so let's do the Euler characteristic. So I'm supposed to do the number of vertices minus the number of edges plus the number of faces. Two plus m is the number of vertices minus the number of edges plus we had eight faces, and it has to be equal to two. Euler told us that. So what do I have? I have 10 minus m is equal to two. The number of moves is eight. We just showed that player two always wins, but what if you had insisted that you wanted to go second? Well, I still could have won.
I could. What would you have done?
I would have started with three crosses instead of two. So if you start with three, then the game ends after 13 moves. And the cool thing about Brussels sprouts is that if we start with n crosses, the game ends after 5n minus 2 moves. And it's the exact same argument we just did, just we add another variable for the number of crosses. So whenever we start with an even number of crosses, player 2 wins, and with an odd number of crosses, player 1 wins. So what I recommend is you ask somebody, do you want to play Brussels sprouts? And you put 2 down. And they'll say, sure. And then you say, do you want to go first or second? And if they say, I want to go second, then I just say, oh, since we already did two crosses, let's add a third one and we'll play with three. People don't notice because the game seems like it should have strategy to it. So people mostly are focusing on the strategy and not assuming that I'm starting them with a losing situation.